Hey guys, this is going to be an installation of the TyrolSport DeadSet subframe collars. Your kit comes with two ARP bolts and six collars. It looks like six upper and six lower. I'll get into the directions and figure that out. These Audi bolts are optional. You can use the V-dub ones or get new V-dub ones, which are skinnier and weird looking, or most people order these Audi bolts just while they're in there. Might as well put those in. So I'm going to get going on this install. One thing I noticed is I normally jack up, I jack up here and put my jack stands under here. That's not going to work this time. That has to come down. So instead, I'll jack up at my rear point, and the chassis is so stiff, it'll lift this side high enough to get a stand right here instead. So I'm going to do it that way. An example of what I just said, I jacked up on the rear, and it also gets the front off the ground so I can get my jack under there. So that's how you can do that. First step is we're going to undo these two bolts holding the downpipe bracket. As seen in TyrolSport's first step here. Next step is you're going to remove those two bolts across from your dogbone here. Close up right there. I'm going to do that next. Very light pressure on those, not that big a deal. I do the front one almost by hand. The back one was a little tighter. These are 16. Just need a small wrench, but it's not tight, as you can see. Those are very different sized bolts, so that'll be pretty obvious when you put them back in. The next step for me is gonna require a lot of concentration. I gotta really get under there and start studying the picture and stuff like that. So let me have a look at this for a little bit. All right, looking from the front of the car, I was too confused, but now it lines up. So your picture here, sorry about the noise. You have your black, the two at the top next here. Go down one to here by the orange one. Then you have three down here, one, two, three. I'm gonna loosen all of these, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Loosen all these 3 to 4 turns. And most of these don't need to come out further than that. Then you're just gonna work on your 6. So I'm gonna loosen these 7 on each side and then get back to you. Oops, sorry about the camera. Then get back to you. One side's loose. You got your 18s. You got some 16s, and you got some 13s. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now I'm gonna do the same thing on the other side. One important thing that someone mentioned, Tyrol did not mention this top one here, which is a real important one. It is part of your main mount. And they don't say to loosen those. Someone mentioned that you should definitely loosen those too before you start doing all this. So I'm gonna take their advice and do that too. It's hidden up there in the hole. I got that one loose up there, and everything creaked a little when I released it, so that's cool. There's stuff under tension there. And everybody always talks about steering rack, sway bars, everything that makes you nervous, like doing this job, like what the hell am I gonna loosen? It's simpler than I thought. I think these two are your sway bar, actually, that hold the bracket here. I can't quite see up there. So you're not getting all crazy with parts. It's really simple. I haven't moved from this position the whole time. Now I really am gonna do the other side real quick. I wanted to mention something real important. Remember I had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. On this driver's side, let's start over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Weird. So your center bolt, I do not have that on the passenger side. Can't even see what it is, like steering maybe. And I do have one here. So it's only on one side, which is strange. So you might see an odd number. I also made sure there's nothing supposed to be in this bolt because I have my finger in the hole, there's nothing there. So it's not a mistake. You might have a center bolt only on one side. Instructions then move to installing the kit. With all the bolts loosened, which I've done, this is the first bolt they tell you to work on. It is at the edge of your control arm here. So it does say the bolt has to be completely removed. This would be this outside bolt, I am pretty sure. This is the main one that goes up into the body, one of the master bolts, and this one will be getting some collars. Quick note for something I did not realize. This is not one of the bolts in the first set I just did. This is an additional bolt that was not even loosened yet. So I got the bolt out of here. You can say, well, how are you going to fit these things in there? Because these two are loose. See, you got some movement. So you can easily pry it just enough to slip that one in there. I'm not going to try doing that with the camera on. Man, this job is nerve-wracking. But you can see, maybe you can see the little gold one up there. And you can make sure it's seated right by pushing this up, and it's in that slot. And I also know that nothing's cross-threaded because I can turn this by hand. So, I mean, if it's that easy to turn, it's definitely good. You just want to snug these up like that for now. Get about 10 turns. I'm very confident that it's not cross-threaded and that it's sunk in the proper hole up top. I might use a mirror later, but this is the prep setup. I'm going to do the same thing to the other outer bolt now. And I forgot to use my Audi bolts right there, so I'm going to go back and get those. These don't look as weak as those V-dub ones I saw, but I'm going to put the Audi ones in anyway. People have mentioned this before, and it is okay that the Audi bolts are a little bit longer. Someone else confirmed that. Don't worry about it. And my first problem. Unless there are different collars, I don't think there are. All the collars have the same size lips, or do they? See, I'm looking at some issues here. Those are for later, the small ones. Let me look at what I got here. See, one of these has a big collar. Okay, that's not it. See, let me put this down. The problem is the stock bolt is a good fit over these, and it even goes inside here. The Audi bolt doesn't go in either of them. So now I'm trying to decide if it's meant to be that way. This isn't flat, so I don't like it having it over the edge like this when I put it up into the car. Let me check it real quick. I guess this is why you have my videos and don't always believe everything you see on the forums. The Audi bolts will not work in these spots. You definitely want the bolt to sink in deep here. You do not want the washer fitting over the crooked edge being a mess. I just talked to Tyrol myself personally. They definitely said use the stock bolt in this position. So it was some misinformation to use Audi in the other four spots because it does not fit. He could get collars that would fit there. He offered that. I said, no, I'm just definitely going with stock. Because if you did go with a bigger collar, you're going to lose a lot of mounting bite too, see, to make it as big as that washer. So just clarifying some information, you cannot use the Audi bolts on all four of these spots. I am using my OEMs on these first two bolts that I'm still working on. All right. So in the task we just did, I just pulled down on that control arm by putting my finger through the square hole, pulled it down, shoved it in there, and then I went ahead, put the bottom one in, then put my bolts up, and they're both loose. So now I'm going to move on to the next set. The next step is the rear bolts. These are the bolts that these are going to replace. These would probably fit in this head right here, which they do. Exactly. These are killer ARPs. Fit right in the head. So you got a bigger circle in those first ones I did, a smaller circle in the second ones. Your steel ones, the rear ones, the ARPs. So these are your two black ones that are coming out. These come out by hand. I mean, it's ridiculous how easy, I shouldn't say that, how easy this is so far. I want to see if these are wobbly. If they're bent, I doubt they are. They're pretty straight. But these are those pesky bolts. See all that crappy design? They're small, they're big. Right there. All right. Let me go look at those ARP stuff. Incidentally, mine are not bent like some people's if they take extreme pressure. Mine don't have a wobble. These ones are tricky, so you might need a little pry bar just to give you a quarter, an eighth of an inch more room to slide those toppers in. See what I got here. I mean, this really is one of the easiest jobs I've done. It's scary. You think it's super advanced, but it's really not. I got my two coppers in these. This is the ARP holes. Remember, closest to your downpipe mount is your ARP holes. You remember that. And you can see up here how it's light. It's not hard. It's not like the wet engine sitting on it. I don't know how that all set up there. But I can push it, and you see it's super flat and nice. It's killer. So it's perfectly seated. The most important part is you're going to make sure these are seated as you carefully tighten it. X pattern, I'll get into all that later. But if you have one of these not in the top hole, you can destroy everything. So the most important part is reassembly. So I did this step, rear bolts removed, insert top collars, and the large part faces down, which I did, and locates the top of the subframe. Page done. Next page, you're going to insert your ARP bolts with your killer collars. Look at that fit. Nice machine. These are expensive, but $200 to fix the whole geometry of your car? Come on. Let's get serious. It's a good deal. These are hard to find. Spoon makes some too, but these are killer right here. The important part, thin coating of anti-seize on the ARP bolts. This is real important for the torque later on, so don't just skip this part and say who cares. What's thin to me? I don't know. I guess that's opinion. Just a little thick, but I'm not going to use it all. Sort of like that, get you some light. I'm not going to coat the whole thing. It did say thin, didn't say get it soaked, wipe some of it off. That's what I call thin. This one already has a nice thin coating. Smear it in a little bit. That's again what I call thin. Just a little bit. Keep it lubed. A half hour later, almost had a heart attack, but I figured it out. So you can learn from me or whatever. These back bolts were really tricky to get started. Now this one, I started by hand. Then for 15 minutes, I was fighting with this one. The subframe moved, I pulled it every which way. Back east, west, north, south, and I couldn't get it started. And I was starting to get real nervous, like I'd have to use the old bolts, which have a tapered seat, easier to center. And then I got it. When I took out this one that fit fine, it's probably just luck. I took the same bolt and put it in this hard side first, wiggled it, and it started by hand. I know they're good now. I used a wrench real carefully, but do not force these. If it's real tight in the first one or two threads or turns, do not force it. You just got to be patient and stop and just keep thinking about it. It has a lot of movement. Eventually, you'll get it. If you just cannot get your ARP, I've been waiting to screw up like that, ARP bolts in, you can use the stockers in here and they go in a lot easier. I just was patient, took a long time. I got them both in. So that was like a half hour right there.
Even with all that, it's not that hard a job. I mean, if that's the hardest thing. The last step, it says, is to do your collars on that big thing through the little hole we saw by the axle. So hopefully I can just bend these down just as easy and pop stuff in there. We'll see how tight they are. And then the final step will be reassembly at the back. So I'm going to try and put the collars in these things next. Same deal again with these misinformed Audi bolt crap. This is the tops. These are the bottoms. So for these last two, I just showed you those. The stock bolt is perfect. That's what you want to use. This Audi bolt looks ridiculous. You do not want it like that. That is not clean, not how it should be. Again, I'm going to use the stock bolts. So purchasing these five Audi bolts was a total waste.
For these here, as you can see, you got plenty of room. It comes down. I would make sure that you get the bushing into the top first. Make sure it's seated. It stays up there, as you can see. The bottom, it's much easier to get that centered. It's a big cone. So I had it in the bottom. I was going to push up. It didn't quite feel seated right. It definitely wasn't this flush. So, and if you have it in the bottom and you start torquing it up, you can bend the edge.
So I recommend pushing all six of these. Make sure they're up, or else watch them real closely with a mirror as you tighten everything. I know this one's fully seated up top. The cone will naturally seat itself as I tighten it. Its hand, see, it's tightening perfectly, its hand loose. It'll pull it into place as it tightens. But make sure your top half is seated rather than the bottom half of the bushing. Before I button up my last bolt, let me just show you what, why the hell we're even doing this. Hopefully you can see right through that hole. See this mounting surface. See, first off, it's not even centered at all. You can see the bolt has been moved way offset. Then on the top, I believe, that you're looking at there, you can see all those rubbing marks. That's from the movement of the subframe moving back and forth. You can see how these cone bronze way up in there, that centers everything and gets it exactly centered where it should be, keeps all your alignment tight. So this shouldn't be sliding anymore on all those marks you can see. Just wanted to make sure I documented that before I buttoned up my last bushing.
Ready for final tightening, reassembly. I am going to follow Tyrol's directions on torque here. First, I'm going to do those four bolts that I kept. I didn't use the Audis, my four stock VW bolts. I'm going to do those to 52 foot-pounds plus a 90-degree turn, a quarter turn. I'm not going to do the 81, 82 foot-pound deal. That is for the Audi bolts, supposedly. But this is Tyrol's kit. They designed it. I trust them. I'm going with this, which is for the stock bolts that I did reuse. The only bolts I did not reuse were the ARP bolts in place of these weird-looking VW bolts. I'm going to do an X pattern with those 18 on the four corners. I'm just going to do a crisscross on those. I'm not going to tighten one side and then the other. You know, use common sense. As you tighten it, keep a real close eye on those top side of those bronze bushings. Make sure they're nice and clean and seated super flat. All right, I got those four X's, those four 18mm VW bolts, cinched up with a tiny wrench. That's all you need. Don't be afraid if it bungs up toward the end. It'll get tight for a minute toward the very end, and then it slips into place. You go, oh shit, did I just strip out the whole thing? You didn't. It's the collar's seating in their cone. I was real scared, but don't be afraid of that. It does get tight toward the end, and then it just goes zzz, and then it's easy again as it centers. I'm actually moving the whole subframe doing this. The only key is make sure you got at least 10 threads in by hand before you start cranking on it, obviously. Make sure it's in there right. I knew it was. I trusted it. I kept turning, and I just felt the bushings pull the subframe into place. It's pretty cool. I'm going to do final torques on these four, then I'm going to move to the next bolts. 52 foot-pounds. I'll start at the corners. You've not done your ARPs yet. Those are next. So I'm starting at one corner. Do 52 foot-pounds. There's 52 foot-pounds. Before I do my 90 degree, I'm going to do my crisscross. 90 degrees will be last. You need a long extension for these other ones. So since I did this one, I'm coming across in an X over to here to this one. Just doing the 52s to start with. Oh, I missed it. Okay, one more. 52 there. Now I'm going to do this lower one over here. Get in there, you son of a bitch. I love working on cars. Whew. It's a common. I think I'll get it on this one. Ah, 52 there. Back to my small one for the last one there. Just gotta remember which one I did. I think I'll go to this corner for the last one. That is correct. Ah. Son of a bitch. 52. All right. I'm gonna go back, do these quarter turns real quick.
And I need some good leverage for this. Get it perfect. All right, I gotta go directly back for my quarter turn. The thing is the angles. It's a hard part of the angle. I'm not gonna let up. I'm just gonna keep doing it till I get it. One done. If I'm trying to tell you the right way to do things, you don't use your torque wrench to do that final tightening. You could damage it. It's possible. Going way over the torque and everything, messing it all up. Use a breaker bar if possible. I'm gonna get a breaker bar to do my last three, and it'll all work the same way. I got this one exactly 90 degrees. I like things perfect. I didn't have a half inch 18. It's missing from my set, I believe. I didn't have an impact for one of these bolts. I forget which one, but now I'm gonna use the big socket so it'll be easier to get these last turns. All right, now the ARP bolts, 90 foot pounds. I got a big torque wrench for this I'm gonna use, not that little pinner one. Now that's a 90 foot pound wrench. I let you experience the last of the collar bolts getting torqued. It's 90 foot pounds. It's a lot easier doing your wheels when you're standing up. My pipes aren't very big. Boom, six collars torqued. Button everything up and I'm done. Started at 1 p.m., it's 2:30, so hour and a half. Still have to tighten up my misc bolts and things here. It's another 5-10 minutes. So roughly an hour and a half for me. Had one mistake. I missed two of the 18 bolts. The instructions do say proceed with tightening the 18s first in the locations which received wedges. That's what I did, but I found more 18 millimeters than I forgot about, which are there on the edges here. Either I wasn't supposed to loosen these, or they're missing from the directions, but I did the X up on both sides. I forgot these 18s as I was doing these 16s. I went, wait a minute, there shouldn't be any big bolts left. So let me torque these ones up real quick too. I'll do the same as the other 18s, 52 plus a quarter turn. Okay, I got those two 18s snugged up to 52 plus a quarter turn on those. Then I did some 16s. I had like three and four, because there was that extra one on one side. I think I did 7 16s. The last ones are like the 13-inch sway bar ones, only till snug. You don't go crazy on those, so there's no torque on them. Just the four tiny 13s are all that's left. Then I put in the four bolts I took out, and I am done. The dogbone mounts are next, and it says 52 foot-pounds for the dogbone mount. Same as all the others, pretty much. No problems getting the dog bolt mount started. You got a little play and stuff. You can kind of pull it around a little bit. Make sure you start these by hand. And I use a tiny little ratchet as I put them in before I torque. Make sure you don't strip nothing. You don't have much torque on it, so it makes you extra careful. Use small ratchets whenever possible. Snug them up tight. Torque them, I won't show you that. Not much you need. The last two bolts in this job. My downpipe front red rubber hanger bolts. It wasn't a hard job. It was just kind of nervous job, because if you strip out a frame bolt or a frame thread, you're totally boned. But I got lucky on that. Let's say overall, car up to car down, I'd say 2 hours is what it took me. And that's making this video too, you know, stopping for every frame. So I'll let you know later how it worked out, changed my steering. I got to see how far my steering wheel's off now. If it's off even further, I might need an alignment. I actually like big O tires for my alignment. You know, the GTIs are terrible with their steering wheels. They actually got my last car perfect, so I do trust them. And they let me adjust the wheel myself and everything to get it just where I wanted it. So if the wheel's straight, the steering wheel, I'm not going to touch it. If it's crooked, I'm going to get my alignment now that I straightened out this subframe.
Don't forget, when you're done, get a little Showtime detailer. Polish up those bronze collars. You want them to look real nice, you know. Every time you crawl into your car, you can look at them and go, man, those are nice looking. Get the grease off them where you worked and stuff. Oh, those things are like gold, man. Last one up here above the camera. Beautiful, man, those are killer. I'm not gonna get the ones up in the hole. Those are too hard to get. But these ones are really cherry now. Look at that, they're gleaming. That's the end.